Good day everyone, welcome to Learn with MN. From this video, we are starting the tutorial series of Inkscape. We will learn Inkscape software step by step and from scratch. So, this tutorial is for complete beginners. So let's get started. Inkscape is an open source software for making vector graphics. It can be illustration, digital art, figures, charts and so on. The default format of Inkscape is SVG, that is scalable vector graphics, while other formats like PNG, JPEG, TIFF can be imported and exported easily. Now, why to use Inkscape? Well, the main reason is that Inkscape is totally free. You don't need even a cent to use it. Just download, install and enjoy. Secondly, the format, SVG, used by Inkscape is ideal for graphics related to web and mobile applications. Another advantage that means a lot is that as compared to other software, Inkscape demands fewer hardware requirements and works smoothly on low-grade computers. In other words, Inkscape is a complete fast package with less space for hard disk. Coming to the installation of Inkscape. Open the browser and search for Inkscape download. Click on this first link. Here the most recent version of Inkscape available is 1.1 and its revision is also uploaded. So, we will download the revised version of 1.1 that is 1.1.1. We recommend to install the most recent version of the software as it includes bug fixes and some new features that previous ones lack. Let's download it for Windows as this system is Windows. If yours is Linux or Mac then you can choose these options accordingly. Click here. Select the architecture. This is 64-bit, click 64. Here three type of installers are available. We will use installer in .exe format. Click it. Your download is started. Wait for its completion. I have already downloaded it, so let's move to its installation. This is the setup file of Inkscape. If you click, you will see that the file size is not very large, it is just 84.8 megabytes. Let's start the setup, double-click it. This is welcome screen of installation. Click next to continue. Next is license agreement, click I agree. Here it is asking to add Inkscape directory to system path, by default it is not added. Keep it as it is. Check this checkbox if you want to create shortcut icon on desktop and click next. Here it is showing the folder where it will be installed. Keep it as it is and click next. Choose a start menu folder for Inkscape shortcut if you like or check this checkbox to not create shortcuts. Click next. Here are the components of Inkscape listed that will be installed. Make sure all are checked and click install. Now, installation is started. It will take few minutes to complete, so I am skipping this part to save time. Here you go, installation is completed. Keep this checked and click finish to run the Inkscape. For first startup, it will take a little longer to load. Before moving to main interface of Inkscape, it will show this welcome screen for making some settings for the interface like canvas, keyboard, and appearance. It also offers dark and light version of interface. I will keep it dark. You can also change the icon's appearance from here. Let's select compacted, small screen. They will look like this. When happy with your settings, click save. Next, this tab is to support the Inkscape if you want. Click thanks. Now this is the important window. Here you can load your existing designs that you have created in Inkscape, or you can choose any built-in template to create your design. For example, in print there are A4, its landscape, US letter, and many other if you drag down. Similarly, there are for screen, for video, social media related templates, and different icon sizes in other. If you do not want to see this screen every time you start Inkscape then uncheck it, but we prefer to keep it checked. Let's select A4 template. Here it is, the main interface of Inkscape. In upcoming videos, we will discuss each element and tool of Inkscape in detail, so stay tuned. If you like this video, please like, subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any update. Thank you for watching.